Hello dear children, welcome back to English literature class. In the last class we discussed the extract questions of Act 3 Scene 2. We discussed 6 extracts. Let's go to the 7th extract. Act 3 Scene 2 of Merchant of Venice. So the 7th extract, please keep open your reader. Myself and what is mine to you and yours is now converted. But now I was a lord of this fair mansion, master of my servants, queen over myself, and even now, but now, this house, these servants, and this same myself are yours, my lord. So these are the words of Portia, which she speaks to Bassanio. Which possessions of hers she is giving to, transferring to Bassanio, after he chose the right casket? That is her house, her palace, her mansion, servants, and herself. Mention three of the wishes of Portia, which expresses a desire to excel in everything. So, for the sake of Bassanio, she wishes to be better. She wants that she should be better than what she is at present. That is, she might be 60 times herself, 1,000 times more beautiful, 10,000 times more rich than she is now. She wants to stand respectable in his eyes. She might be worth more than what one can be in terms of virtues, beauty, and property and friends. Then on what condition? On what condition does he give the ring to Bassanio? How does giving the ring become a part of the main plot in the story? So the condition she put forth was that if he lost the ring or gave it away, or if he had parted with it, that would be a sign that his love for her was dead, and she would get an opportunity to accuse him for that. Then how it is connecting? How does giving the ring become a part of the main plot in the story? After giving the ring, Bassanio loses the ring. Loses in which way? He gives the ring to someone. When Bassanio goes to Belmont, there he gives the ring to someone. So that way, main story, that is the main plot, is Venice and its problems. Now these two are connected. Then give the meaning of, let it presage the ruin of your love, and may my vantage to exclaim on you. So please write from the paraphrase. This is a direct meaning. Write in same tense, and further you can explain it in indirect speech. Then after Portia's speech, what does Bassanio say in his excitement? He says that Portia's love and modesty deprived him of his words. And what assurance does he give to her about the ring? He gives assurance that when the ring leaves his finger, it can be by death also, she may say with certainty that Bassanio is dead. Next one. Graciano, my Lord Bassanio and my gentle lady, I wish you all the joy that you can wish, for I am sure you can wish none for me. And when your honours mean to solemnize the bargain of your faith, I do beseech you, even at that time I may be married too. Let's see the questions. The first question, is the context in which Graciano speaks these words. What was the context? Bassanio chose the right casket. And one Portia, Nerissa, greets him that time and then wishes great joy for them. Thereafter, Graciano speaks these words and wishes him joy and all happiness. What request does Graciano make to Bassanio? What was Graciano's request? To solemnize his marriage also. When Bassanio celebrates his engagement, he should allow Graciano to marry Nerissa at the same time. Nerissa, he didn't say Nerissa, he should allow him to marry at the same time. What condition does Bassanio put for regarding Graciano's request? Graciano, sir, he put the condition that as soon as he finds out he can get a wife, he would allow him to marry. Then explain how Graciano's fortune too stood upon caskets. When Bassanio would Portia, Graciano would Nerissa. And explain Graciano's fortune too stood upon caskets. Nerissa, that time Nerissa said that on she would marry Graciano provided Bassanio chooses the right casket and wins Portia. She put forward the condition that only if Bassanio chooses the right casket and win Portia and marries her, Nerissa would marry Graciano. Then how has Graciano and Nerissa episode added humor to the story? In this scene you can see that whatever Bassanio and Portia do, Graciano and Nerissa blindly follow them. They are their mistress and master, and blindly they follow Graciano and Bassanio and Portia. Then father, you can see in the characterization Nerissa and Graciano, the romance and marriage of Nerissa and Graciano strengthen the old belief that characters in association with the nobility are themselves ennobled. Graciano has been foolish and aggressive before meeting Bassanio, whose company led him to experience the joy of true love. Nerissa, though a maid, had been educated by her mistress so as to become worthy of winning a gentleman's love. Then besides Graciano and Nerissa proposal, there is another ordinary couple is in love. Name the couple and state how they will be united. So who are the other couple? Other couple are Lorenzo and Jessica. Lorenzo or Jessica, and they also will be united once Portia goes to Venice and save Antonio from the clutches of Shylock. Then there are some shrewd contents in your same paper that steals a color from Bassanio's cheek. Some dear friend dead, else nothing in the world could turn so much the constitution of any constant man. So the first question is, where does the scene take place? In a room in Portia's palace or house at Belmont. Who brings a letter? Celerio brings a letter. Then how does Portia conclude that there is some bad news in the letter? She saw that Bassanio's face was turning pale. And what could be the bad news according to Portia? She concludes that Bassanio's best friend would have died. Otherwise, a constant man's cheek will not turn into pale. So she concludes his closest friend would have died. Okay, nothing else can take the color of Bassanio's cheeks. Then what right Portia now have to know from Bassanio to the contents of the letter? Bassanio chooses the right casket and wins Portia. Portia accepts him as his lord. And now they are one, and she feels that since they are one now, and since Bassanio has chosen the right casket, he has got the right to tell her, or she has got the right to ask about the contents. Briefly state what Bassanio told Portia about the bond and the destruction of Antonio's cargo ship. So here you can write letter, whatever the letter contained. Some unpleasant words were there, and Bassanio is deeply indebted to Antonio. Antonio, for Bassanio's sake, signed a bond with his enemy, and letter is the body of his friend, and the words are the wounds from which blood is gushing out. And he also gave the news that Antonio's sheep got wrecked. What did Celerio say about Shylock's insistence on the forfeiture of Antonio's bond? What happens to the bond at the end of the play? That is insistence, Antonio's, Celerio, yeah, Shylock's insistence. That is, you can go to page number 137 of your reader. That he says that he has never seen a creature in the form of a man so eager and greedy to destroy another man. And Shylock, morning and evening, plies to Duke and appeals him. And also threatens legal action against the country system of justice if he is denied the bond. And Duke and other merchants and other noblemen also try to persuade Shylock to come out of the bond, not to take the bond, but he does not agree to that. What happens to the bond at the end of the play? At the end of the play, Shylock could not take the bond, could not fulfill the bond. Portia, who came there as, came to Venice as a lawyer, saves Antonio from the clutches of Shylock, and he could not take the bond. And next extract, Jessica, when I was with him, I have heard him swear to Tubal and Chus, his countrymen, that he would rather have Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the sum that he did owe him. So, who are Tubal and Chus? They are another Jews, very close friends of Shylock. Then what did Jessica hear? That is, she heard him tell Tubal and Chus and other Jews that he would rather have a pound of Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the debt. And children, next question. What could the Duke, law and influence citizens do to prevent Shylock from taking his cruel forfeiture? They used all their powers to dissuade Shylock from taking the bond, but they could not do. They tried their level best to dissuade him. What is the danger if the forfeiture is denied to Shylock as per the terms of the bond? What is the danger? Shylock would take legal action against the city's governors and would question about the rights of foreigners in the city of Venice. So, what he will do? He would take legal action against the city's governors and would question about the rights of foreigners in the city of Venice. What does Portia offer to do in terms of payment to Shylock? Cash. This question. Portia offered double the amount, then double of 6,000, and then three times of that. She was also ready to give gold, that means as much as money Bassanio wanted to save Antonio. Then what does Antonio's letter state about his last wish? What does his last wish show about his character? What is his last wish to see Antonio before his death? It shows his sincere love for Antonio. Sorry, for Bassanio. Then coming to the last extract. Portia's words. First go with me to church and call me wife, and then away to Venice to your friend. For never shall you lie by Portia's side with an unquiet soul. So please read the extract fully. What were Portia's secret plans in sending Bassanio to Venice? After sending Bassanio to Venice, she had a plan to disguise herself as a lawyer and Nerissa as her assistant and go to Venice to rescue Antonio. Meaning, call me wife with an unquiet soul. So please write from the paraphrase. Here it is in direct speech, that is me in the first person. Your meaning also should be in the first person. Further, if you want to explain, you can explain in indirect speech. What is Bassanio supposed to do as far as Antonio's forfeiture of the bond is concerned? Bassanio is supposed to go to Belmont and offer double the amount. If he does not agree, Shylock does not agree, he should offer double of 6,000 or 3 times or 20 times more. So he should immediately go to, he was supposed to go immediately to Venice. What would Portia and Nerissa supposed to do, to be doing in Belmont after their husbands leave for Venice? What did they really do? So they were supposed to disguise. Sorry, they were supposed to live as maids and widows after their husbands go to Venice. What did they really do? They disguised as lawyer and lawyer's assistant. Portia as a lawyer and Nerissa as a lawyer's assistant. Then they went to Venice to save Antonio. And how important is a scene for the forward movement of the storyline? It is very important because in this scene, Casca's story is completed. Venice and Belmont are connected now. Antonio's life will be saved. And all the three pairs of lovers will be united. Then, next question, Portia takes over as a over the leadership in the play. What are your views on this statement? So this you can see in workbook, in Portia, Portia's characterization. So Portia's leadership qualities, intellect, that is a fourth paragraph of Portia's characterization, Portia's intellect, resourcefulness and leadership qualities manifested in her immediate reaction to Antonio's plight. She urges Bassanio to marry her soon and travel to Venice with her money to save Antonio. Portia is able to conceive and successfully execute the strategy of using the lawyer's disguise. So her leadership quality is shown here. She disguised as a lawyer and went to Venice and saved Antonio from the clutches of Shylock. So children, like that we have completed Act 3, Scene 2 of Merchant of Venice. And it was a very important act because there are so many important speeches. So please complete your workbook. And when you come to school, we'll be checking your workbooks. Thank you. Have a nice time.